Bibles tonight, please. We're going to turn now to the Word of God, to the New Testament, and we're turning to the Acts of the Apostles, chapter number 16, please. The Acts of the Apostles, and we're turning to chapter number 16. And when you come to Acts chapter 16, come down with me, please, to verse number 13, and it's there we'll commence our scripture reading tonight. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 16, and commencing to read from verse number 13. And on the Sabbath, we went out of the city by a riverside, where prayer was wont to be made. And we sat down and spake unto the women which resorted thither. And a certain woman named Lydia, a seller of purple of the city of Thyatira, which worshipped God, heard us, whose heart the Lord opened, that she attended unto the things which were spoken of Paul. And when she was baptized and her household, she besought us, saying, If ye have judged me to be faithful to the Lord, come into my house and abide there. And she constrained us. And it came to pass, as we went to prayer, a certain damsel possessed with a spirit of divination met us, which brought her masters much gain by soothsaying. The same followed Paul and us, saying, These men are the servants of the Most High God, which show unto us the way of salvation. And this did she many days. But Paul, being grieved, turned and said to the Spirit, I command thee in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her. And he came out of her the same hour. And when her masters saw that the hope of their gains was gone, they caught Paul and Silas and drew them into the marketplace unto the rulers, and brought them to the magistrate, saying, These men, being Jews, do exceedingly trouble our city, and teach customs which are not lawful for us to receive, neither to observe, being Romans. And the multitude rose up together against them, and the magistrates rent off their clothes and commanded to beat them. And when they had laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely, who, having received such a charge, thrust them into the inner prison and made their feet fast in the stocks. And we know that the Lord will add his blessing to the reading of his own precious truth tonight. Our scripture reading tonight commences with certain people. Certain people tonight that are so much like people who I know. And they're so much like people that I love. Because you see, in our scripture reading this evening, we come to a certain group of ladies. And there were ladies who were sincere. Do you know, I know so many people tonight, and they are so sincere. Sincere in all they do. Sincere in all they say, religiously speaking. So sincere tonight. But they're not saved. People can be so sincere tonight. Religiously sincere. But they're not saved. And that's the tragedy. Wonder you like that tonight. You're so sincere religiously, But you're not saved tonight. You see, that's what religion does. Religion makes people believe, as long as you're sincere, you're all right. Well, you're not all right. And our scripture reading commenced tonight with people who were so religious. You can be so religious tonight. Religious but not right with God. Kilkeel is coming down with people tonight who are so religious but they're not right with God. The whole Northern Ireland, the north of Ireland tonight is coming down with people so sincere, not saved, so religious, but they're not right. You can be so religious, dear, but not right with God. Oh, friend, this evening, I know so many people tonight, and I'll tell you, they're good people. There's people I know tonight not saved. And you know something, they would get up at the hour of midnight and they would go to Cork tonight if they knew they would do you a good turn. I know so many people tonight and they're sincere and they're religious, and I'll tell you this tonight, they would put any Christian, professing Christian, to shame on how they live. You can be sincere tonight, but not saved. And you can be religious tonight, and not ready. Not ready for what, George? Not ready to meet God. You can be religious and not ready today. You can be religious tonight and not be ready for eternity. Remember the Old Testament, book of Numbers, chapter 22. You'll meet a man there who wasn't a heathen. His name was Balaam. Balaam was a man who believed in God. Balaam was a man who believed in prayer. Balaam was a man who even had the privilege of hearing God's voice. God spoke to Balaam directly. Balaam said some lovely things about God. Do you know what Balaam said about God? God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. But do you know what Balaam said in Numbers chapter 23 and verse 10? This is what Balaam said. Let me die the death of the righteous. Let my last end be like his. Balaam was a man who wanted to die right. Balaam was a man who wanted to die the death of the Christian. Sure, listen, sir, you want to die right tonight. Sure, you want to die right, love. That was Balaam's plea. He wanted to die right, but here was Balaam's problem. He wasn't prepared to live right. You know what I have learned over the years? Everybody wants the death of the Christian, but nobody wants the life of the Christian. Everybody wants to die the death of the saved. Don't give me the life of the saved. Wonder's that you tonight? Oh, you want to die, right? You want the Christian's death, love, but you don't want the Christian's life. You know what happened, Balaam? Balaam died. And Balaam perished with the enemies of God. You can be so sincere. You can be so religious. And perish tonight in a lost sinner's hell. But we come tonight to a riverside. Not to a church building, but to a riverside tonight. We have here a group of women, and there's one stands out, and she's named in our Bible reading tonight. Her name's called Lydia. And God wants you to learn four things about Lydia tonight. And I could guarantee you now that I could relate this woman in this way to so many people in the kingdom of Moore. And I'll tell you why. Because this woman, like so many people in the kingdom of Mourn tonight, she had a religious condition. Let me tell you something about Lydia tonight. She believed in prayer. Verse number 13, she believed in prayer. And in verse number 14, she believed in worship. That's one thing about Lydia tonight. She believed in prayer, and she believed in worship. If there ever was a woman who lived like a Christian and who behaved like a Christian and got on like a Christian, it was Lydia. There's a lot of people tonight, and they live and behave like a Christian, but they're not saved. Oh, they'll go to their place of worship, but they're not saved. They've got religion, but they haven't got salvation. But you know something about this woman tonight? Even though she believed in prayer, and even though she believed in worship, her heart was as dark as night, because her heart was closed to Christ. Wonder's that your heart tonight? Oh, you believe in going to the house of God. You believe in prayer. But tonight your heart's closed to Christ. You can be religious and your heart is dark as night. You can be so sincere and your heart tonight can be as black as hell. Because you see, that's where religion puts you tonight. This woman, Lydia, she was a woman with a religious condition. Wonder's that you tonight? You're someone tonight with a religious condition. Do you remember Nicodemus, who came to Jesus by night? He was a master of the Jews. He was a man tonight who was religious, but he wasn't saved, but thank God he got saved. Do you remember Judas Iscariot, one of the 12? He preached the gospel, performed miracles. His heart was as dark as night. Poor Lydia. All she had was a religious condition. As I've already said tonight, there's many in the kingdom of Mourn like her. A religious condition. You read through your Bibles, and you, what you'll find in your Bibles tonight, people tonight who have a religious condition or who had a religious condition, there's very few of them ever saved. You'll read through the four Gospels. Very few of the religious people there got saved. In fact, if you read through the four Gospels, you'll find that people who had the religious condition were the very people who opposed Christ. They were the very people that opposed the truth. I remember one 12th of July speaking to a man in the assembly field about the need of salvation. Oh, collarette on, the bowler hat on, and umbrella and all. Man, he looked the part. And I talked to him about the way of salvation. He says, I don't need that nonsense, he says. Salvation's nonsense, nonsense. I says, what do you mean it's nonsense, Noel? What do you mean? You see this business about needing to get saved, nonsense. I says, Noel, The Bible says that we all have sinned and have come short of the glory of God. Nonsense, he says. I don't need that. That's not for me. Rice says, no. Maybe I would need, and you would need, to tear the New Testament out of your Bible. Because it's in the New Testament where we're taught tonight we all have sinned and have come short of the glory of God. And it's in the New Testament tonight where we read, neither is there salvation in any other, for there's none other name under heaven given amongst men whereby we must be saved. People with a religious condition tonight still lost. There's so many like that in this town. There's so many like that tonight in our families. There's so many like that in the north of Ireland tonight and in the south of Ireland. Religious but still lost. Religious but still on the way to hell. Religious tonight. And still in darkness. Lydia, she had a religious condition. There's something else about Lydia God wants us to see tonight. There's something that Lydia got that you need tonight. Do you know what Lydia got? It doesn't really stand out, but I can guarantee it happened to her. Lydia got real conviction. Do you know that's how salvation begins tonight? It begins with a real conviction, because Paul spoke unto these women. And when Paul spoke to these women, something happened. Do you know what happened? God made these women, and God made Lydia especially tonight, to waken up to her real need. Tonight, dear unsaved friend, you need a waking up. As Paul spoke to these women that resorted there by the river bank, friend, God spoke, I believe, through the lips of the apostle. That's how God speaks today. God speaks through the lips of men, men who preach God's truth. And Lydia was awakened to her spiritual need. You know, friend, I wonder, are you awakened tonight to your spiritual need? I could guarantee you now, Paul talked to Lydia about, listen, Lydia, you might be religious, but you're not saved, dear. You might be sincere in all you do, Lydia, but you're still going to hell. And Lydia, you might be a woman of prayer, and you might be a woman who believes in worship. Here's something you might not know, Lydia. Christ, when he was crucified to the cross, was crucified there to the cross for you. Here's something tonight that a lot of sinners don't know. Religious people don't know. And what religious people are blind till tonight, that when Christ went to the cross, he was made sin for us. While he was on the cross, Lydia, he took your sins and your sorrows, and he made them his very own. And there he bore the burden to Calvary, and there he suffered and died alone. Lydia, this was all for you, love. And I believe, Lydia, listen. I wonder tonight, are you listening? Do you realize tonight that the Lord Jesus went to the cross for you? Wonder tonight, oh yes, you believe in prayer and you're religious and you believe in worship, but tell me, do you know that Jesus went to the cross for you? Do you realize tonight he died for you? Do you realize he shed his blood for you? Because there's a lot of people tonight, religious people, don't know that. Let me tell you tonight, Christ went to the cross at Calvary to suffer and to bleed and die for this world. And he went to the cross to suffer and to bleed and to die for you. You know why? There was no other good enough to pay the price for sin. He only could unlock the gate of heaven to let us in. I remember it was May 1993. Sam Workman had a tent mission in Laurelville, outside Tandragee. It was a Friday night too. And Sam Workman preached that night from the great text found in Job chapter 33. I was there. You know what the text said? For God speaketh once, yea, twice, yet man perceiveth it not. And that night, friend, Sammy Workman preached from that text and preached with all his heart. I remember after the meeting was over, I was talking to somebody outside the tent door who was collecting the hymn books. And two women left the tent. One was in floods of tears. Do you know what she said? She says, I've been a church goer all my life, and that wee man up there has told me things I've never heard before. And glory to God, that wee woman was under conviction of sin. And glory to God, she went into the wee caravan, and there she got gloriously and wonderfully saved. What awakened her? God awakened her. God's truth. It's God's truth tonight. Not oil tripe. God's truth awakens sinner. Because you see tonight, you can be so religious and so lost. Is that you tonight? Is that all you have to hold on to? Oh, I believe tonight she had real conviction. You remember this tonight. I believe Paul said to Lydia, Lydia, listen, dear. You're going to be accountable to God someday, dear. And you must prepare to meet God. Listen, dear, this evening. Doesn't matter how religious you are. You must prepare to meet God. And it doesn't matter how sincere you are, you're still a sinner. And the Lord Jesus said, if ye die in your sin, where I am, there ye cannot come. Do you see Lydia tonight? The woman who had a religious condition. And she had a real conviction. I'll tell you something else about her tonight. She had a real conversion. Do you know how I know she had a real conversion? Because it was the Lord who opened her heart. God can open hearts tonight. And God always uses his word to open hearts. wasn't Paul who opened her heart. It was the Lord. Ivan Thompson had a brother called Jimmy. And Ivan witnessed to Jimmy for most of his life. Wouldn't listen to Ivan. Jimmy was ambushed in a police car one night, and Ivan said when he went to the hospital, "This is it, Jimmy's going to get saved tonight." Ivan went to talk to him about his soul in the hospital, but he was still as hard as nails. But 2 years after this, Ivan got a phone call one Lord's Day afternoon. Who was it from? It was from Jimmy. Ivan, he said, "Yes, Jimmy, got saved this morning." Ivan says, "What do you mean you got saved this morning?" He says, "Is Billy Graham over?" "No, no," he says, "I got saved in church this morning." And Ivan had suspicion. He says, "Jimmy, tell me how you got saved." He says, "Well, the wee minister got up on the reading desk. And he read a few verses from Revelation chapter 3. And he says he got to verse 20. And he read those words, 'Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man heareth my voice and openeth the door, I will come in.'" He closed the Bible, Ivan, he got up into the pulpit, he talked about his holidays. But he says through that one verse, God spoke to me. And through that one verse, God brought him under conviction. And Ivan, or Jimmy, was gloriously saved. That's what happened, Lydia, you know, tonight. That's what happened. You know what the Lord Jesus says tonight? Except you be converted. You might be christened tonight, no use. Might be confirmed tonight, no use. Jesus says, except you be converted and become as little children, you shall in no ways enter into the kingdom of heaven. See Lydia tonight. She was a religious woman who became a Christian. A woman that you need. Do you know your need tonight? You're sincere, but you're not saved. You're religious, but you're not right with God. Tonight you need to come and make the Savior yours tonight. May that be so of you that's not saved tonight. May God bless this word to our hearts tonight. Our closing.